Popular notions of Cesar Chavez today are often really positive and really simplistic. He's known as a nonviolent organizer who planned strikes, the big great boycotts, and marches across California to support the rights of farm workers. However, he held his own politics of exclusion that aren't really talked about today. Even in advocating for farm workers, Cesar Chavez was exclusionary and violent toward undocumented farm workers in the United States. At the time, most of the agricultural work on the West Coast was not being done by immigrant labor, but these folks were still getting paid horrible wages, they were made to work while poisonous pesticides were being sprayed on the fields they worked on, they were made to live in poor shacks and experience exploitive working conditions. So Chavez and others were organizing strikes so that the farm workers would refuse to work until their bosses, the growers, met their demands for higher wages, for better living conditions, for less exposure to pesticides, and more. But when farm workers striked, it became really easy for the growers to simply contract more immigrant labor from Mexico. So there were tides of undocumented workers coming into the US that were breaking the strike and that were going into the fields that the US workers had refused to work on in order to demand for these changes. This was happening all across California and also in states like Texas, Arizona, New Mexico. Members of the union Chavez had helped form, today known as the United Farm Workers or the UFW, were extremely violent against these undocumented workers, who they saw as a threat to their strike. A lot of members of the UFW created what they called wet lines, where more than 300 union members would stand patrol a stretch of the border between US states and Mexico and physically attack and abuse undocumented folks so that they wouldn't cross to the US and so that they wouldn't work on the fields. A director of the UFW and a really close friend of Cesar Chavez used to say, "If we can get the illegals out of California, we will win the strike overnight." And Chavez often turned his head when all of this violence was breaking out. In fact, in 1969, he actually testified in front of Congress urging them to enforce more law and order against illegals and green card holders who were breaking farm worker strikes. Chavez argued that to improve wages and working conditions, the government had to enforce existing laws against Mexican immigrants and create even harsher laws to resist Mexican immigrants even more. So he wanted fines for growers who were choosing to hire undocumented immigrants during a strike, and he wanted penalties against those immigrants who accepted work during a strike or a boycott. He said, "What we ask is some way to keep the illegals and green card holders from breaking out strikes. Some civil remedy against growers who employ behind our picket lines those who have not permanently moved their residency to the United States." At the beginning of the grape harvest, Chavez told reporters that the union had recorded more than 2,200 undocumented workers on ranches in just the Fresno area. And then soon after, he snitched on those undocumented workers and called the Social Security Administration to see what could be done about what he called the problem of undocumented workers who didn't have American Social Security numbers. In 1974, Cesar Chavez held protests against the INS, or the Immigration Naturalization Service, similar to what ICE is today, for not restricting undocumented immigration enough. And he held demonstrations in Sacramento for more state regulation against undocumented workers. And as a result, later that year, after the protests and demonstrations, the Justice Department announced its plan to begin massive deportations of undocumented immigrants. After these demonstrations and the heated debates, in 1986, Congress passed the Immigration and Reform Control Act, or IRCA, that made it for the first time illegal to hire undocumented immigrants. However, the growers still pushed for the right to import temporary workers in the event of labor shortages. So basically, they created an exception where growers could hire undocumented labor only if there was a strike. And even in this legislation that Cesar Chavez advocated for, the growers were still able to make exceptions. And though this exception expanded visa programs for some seasonal workers, IRCA ultimately made it harder for undocumented immigrants to be hired today. And so the stance that Cesar Chavez had against undocumented workers, though it might have been seen as valid at the time of the strikes and organizing, it's important to remain critical about his position and really hesitant to associate him with immigrant rights movements because he actually held a really conservative view of undocumented immigrants and what he called illegal immigration.